Thanks, CJ. My name is Jeff Wagner. I lead our studio UI teams. I'm thrilled to be here tonight. We have a lot of great stuff going on in studio, and I'm excited to share it with all of you. I feel fortunate. I've been able to do a lot of different things at Netflix, a lot of work on the consumer product and ship a lot of product. But studio is really special. It's super unique, the impact we get to have, the partners we get to work with, and the challenges that we take on. And so I'll share a couple stories tonight that I hope will give you some insight into how we go about building product. And so when you think about Netflix UI, you're likely to think about our consumer product. And on the consumer side, our goal is to delight our members. We want to make a great product, so when you're sitting down to choose entertainment, maybe you come to Netflix because it's just a little bit easier to use and a little bit easier to find the content you want to enjoy. Our goal there is to build rich, cinematic, frictionless, performant user experiences. The user experiences you see on your TV, web, and mobile applications. We're iterating a lot. We're A-B testing. We're trying to make it easier and easier to choose a title. And I've heard from a lot of you, we still have a long ways to go on that. But we're working on it, and we're working on making playback higher quality and seamless. On the studio side, our goals are similar. We have a very different user base, but the applications that we're making are critical for our partners to actually produce these movies and TV shows. Everything from a scheduling app. Somebody's got to plan when we're actually going to release that film. They've got to figure out the milestones, the dependencies, the resources, the cast and the crew. And they got to do that hundreds of times across movies and documentaries. And so if we can make a really great user experience, if we can make that frictionless, if we can make it seamless to tie into all these data sources, it'll make it that much easier to get their job done, to collaborate with their partners, and we believe it'll end up ultimately in better storytelling on the service for our members. So how do we go about delighting? And because it's a Silicon Valley talk, and it's entertainment at scale, how do we delight at scale? For us, it's all about building amazing teams. When we bring these product teams together, it's researchers, product managers, designers, front-end and back-end engineers. And it takes a lot of hard work to figure out what is that great product experience that's really going to enable these teams. So we don't want to spend our time fighting infrastructure or rewriting components again and again. We really want to give these teams context, and we want to let them iterate towards building great solutions. So we invest quite a bit in initiatives that are going to make us more productive. It might be decreasing build times or simplifying deployment or some runtime tracing to make it easier to debug. And so tonight I'll talk to you briefly about just a couple initiatives that have been really successful for enabling our teams to move really fast and focus on building great products. The first initiative I'll talk to you about is our Hawkins Design System. Hawkins, of course, comes from the name Hawkins National Laboratory, the lab featured in our hit show Stranger Things. And the Hawkins Lab is infamous for opening up the gate to the upside down. Lucky for us, we didn't do that. We didn't make contact with Demogorgons. But we did bring engineers and designers together to fundamentally alter how we build the applications in the studio. And so the idea of a design system was not a new one. We tried this a couple times in studio and failed. But we finally sort of broke through because of a strong partnership and alignment with our design team. Our design team laid down these foundational building blocks that would really be the basis for building great applications. And then our engineering team came and turned those building blocks into React components with TypeScript and Material UI and gave us a design system that we can just pull into each application, and enabling developers to move really quickly. And for our users, they got a consistent experience across apps. When you're dealing with a lot of different apps, that helps reduce that friction. Second thing I'll talk about is our approach to integrating with data services. So when we started this pitch to play initiative, we had only a handful of applications and microservices. Our UI spoke to these microservices through an API, and that API for one microservice might be REST, another gRPC, and a third GraphQL. Our UI would speak to these data sources, these microservices, aggregate the data, apply some business logic in a back-end for front-end approach. But as our applications multiplied and our microservices multiplied, this became extremely time-consuming. We were spending all this time fetching data, aggregating data for a single app. And what we really want to do is we want to shift our APIs from just being providers of data that say, here, come and get it, to APIs that help us build great product experiences. They provide the exact data in the exact format that we want. And so we've invested in our Studio Edge architecture. It allows us to construct queries to fetch data across lots of entities. We have a decentralized schema with each domain team merging seamlessly onto a unified graph. And we simplified our data access around GraphQL. Our data structures have become more graph-oriented in Studio Edge, making it a natural fit, as well as the strongly typed nature and robust ecosystems made it a pleasure to debug our APIs. So let's put it all together. Now we have Hawkins, we have Edge, but we still have these really chaotic environments. Our physical production teams are building, responsible for bringing cast and crew together around the world to actually do that filming in the production of movies and TV shows. And these are independent contractors spinning up quickly, and like CJ talked about, they're using fax machines and other technologies that are probably suboptimal for collaboration. But it's, we know there's a great opportunity to introduce technology, but it's also risky. You have people running around filling multiple roles. If you introduce product that is full of friction or error-prone, you not only don't help them, but you actually risk distracting them and slowing them down. And ultimately, that could be a worse production. So our production UI team and our production backend team came together, and they wanted to revamp one of our messaging apps, Prodigal Distribution. This is a widely adopted app that's critical for delivering documents to our partners. It provides secure file delivery for things like scripts and schedules and call sheets. And our first iteration was serviceable, but it was full of friction and lacked key features. So we brought these teams together. We used user interviews. We visited productions. We really tried to understand the problem, the challenges, so that we could build a great product. And now with Hawkins, we could lay out a user interface and iterate it on days versus weeks. With Studio Edge, we didn't spend so much time fetching data across all these entities. We were able to streamline that and iterate really quickly. And so the result is that we can move really fast and build really great products for our partners. So we've done a lot, but we have so much more work to do. We're far from done. And so if you'd love to learn more, talk about what we're doing, go in more in depth, we'll be over here at the UI engineering space. And next up, I have Christine Mitchell from our promotional and media marketing team.